Foundation. Arthur Caplan is the director of the Center for Bioethics at the University of Pennsylvania. He tweeted this challenge to Congresswoman Bachmann. So here's the deal. She has 1 week to produce her quote-unquote victim. She pays $10,000 to a pro-vaccine group. If she can't, I pay $10,000 to a charity of her choice if she does. Art Caplan joins me now. So you just heard Congresswoman Bachmann's explanation today that she wasn't speaking as a doctor or a scientist during the debate, but afterwards was merely relaying what a distraught mother had told her. Is that an explanation to you or good enough for you?
Well, I'm certainly willing to say she wasn't speaking as a doctor or scientist because she was pretty far off the planet in that area, and it's not acceptable. She's fear-mongering, Anderson. There are about 4,000 women in the U.S. who die every year from cervical cancer, 450,000 worldwide. She said in that clip, and has said it a couple of times, you got to take that into account. That vaccine is dangerous. That's completely inappropriate.
You wrote an op-ed a few days ago in which you said that this issue was, and I want to quote it right, you said it was, quote, being debated by politicians who arguably could not be more self-interested in scoring cheap debating points, even at a cost of possibly killing young women. That's strong stuff. You really think that politicians in this debate are killing young women or could be killing young women?
I do. And the reason I was tough about it, I said, look, you got 4,000 deaths. These vaccines that are out there can prevent many of them. When you scare people, moms, when you scare girls, when you scare women and say, oh, this vaccine is too risky, you are, in a sense, killing these people if they then say, well, I'm not going to try these vaccines. And I think overall, our entire health policy with respect to vaccines has been just a product of fear-mongering, ignorance, kind of kooky statements. It's time to demand better from our politicians. You know, in one sense, Anderson, there's only one question. You got a ton of Americans who aren't getting vaccines. What are you politicians going to do about that?
Are you maybe suggesting that there was no person who came up to Bachmann, or do you think there was a person who came up, but she just shouldn't have put forth what this person said because there's no scientific validity to it?
Yeah, great question. I don't doubt somebody came up to her, but you don't put that into your statements. You don't go on national television and repeat it and repeat it. That's an anecdote. It's not verified. You don't know if the woman's telling the truth or even understand what's going on. It's like saying, gosh, you know, I was attacked by aliens and they abducted me, and what is the government going to do to stop this?
You also take issue with Bachmann's stance against mandatory vaccinations. I mean, there's the medical stuff, which we've been talking about, that she has no evidence for. Or, you know, she doesn't want the government mandating, I guess, in this particular case, this vaccine. Why are you...
Yeah, well, you know, she went off on a tirade about government-mandated vaccines. You know, it'll come as some surprise to those in the military to find out that she's opposed to government-mandated vaccines, since every person in the military gets a government-mandated vaccine. I haven't seen a whole lot of consent discussion going on in that setting. Lots of kids have to get vaccines to go to school. We have a lot of mandates. But what she didn't say was we usually give some ability to opt out. So when I say, yeah, I think we should be mandating vaccines, all I'm saying is let's presume that it's good to give them. Let's presume it's good to save lives. Let's presume we're sick of seeing people die from the flu, from mumps, measles, from HPV. And let's, in fact, then say, okay, under what circumstances can you opt out of it? But, you know, there's nothing all that spooky about a mandate. I don't think the vaccine police are coming to your house and dragging your daughter down the street and injecting her.
And there was an opt-out provision in the Texas case that
Indeed.
She was referring to. She's saying, though, it shouldn't be mandated, that basically it should be opt-in, that parents have the option to opt-in.
Well, you know, I'd love it to be opt-in in one sense. That's great. But you don't run around then saying, holy mackerel, somebody came up to me and said, my daughter, in her words, got retarded after getting a vaccine. I mean, is that the information we're going to have people opt in on? We got to do better than that. And there's no excuse in this political time to let politicians get away with it. Somebody said to me, "Hey, you bet. That's kind of a gimmick." You bet. I'm willing to use gimmickry if that's what it takes to fight ignorance.
So you got the $10,000 ready to go?
If she comes forward? I got my checkbook handy. I'm waiting.
All right. Art, we'll check in with you.